Hello, welcome to the smart board. In this example, we're going to take a look at the pressure that is needed to have water flowing at a velocity of about 10 centimeters per second through a horizontal pipe. But it's not a standard pipe, it's more kind of a duct. So let me draw first our geometry. Rather than a cylindrical pipe, we have a rectangular pipe. It has a height h of 1 centimeter. It has a width w of 5 centimeter, and it has a total length l of 10 meter. Water is flowing through this at a velocity, average velocity coming in here, v of 10 meter per second. And the question we'd like to know, what pressure drop is required? Rephrased, how much higher is the pressure here than at the exit?
Okay.
From the theory, we learned how to do that. Delta P equals 4F, Fanning's friction factor, length over hydraulic diameter, times half rho V squared. The point here is twofold. One, we need to find the hydraulic diameter. Because it's not a cylindrical tube, we need to use that the hydraulic diameter is 4 times the area through which the water is flowing. I could mark that in yellow. There's this. Divided by S, which is the wetted perimeter, which is going to be the 4 sides. So, I have that this is 4 times the dashed area, which is width times height, divided by the 4 walls, the length of that, which is 2 times W plus 2 times H. We do know both 5 centimeters and 1 centimeter, so if you equate this, you get something like 1.7 centimeter as the hydraulic diameter, as if it's now a tube. Okay, that's part one. Part two is that we need to find the Fanning friction factor. That's a function of the Reynolds number, which is now the Reynolds number based on the hydraulic diameter. So it's rho V d hydraulic over viscosity. Since it's water in SI units, this is 10 to the minus 3, 10 to the plus 3. We know the velocity average, 10 meters a second. We just computed the h, so I can find the Reynolds number. 10 to the minus 2 from this gives me 3, 4, minus 2 is 2. And a 3 is 10 to the 5th, and a 1, this is a 1.6 10 to the 5th. If you just put in the numbers, you get this one out, which means highly turbulent. Okay, then I know that I need to find F via a graph that I can look up, a table, a graph, where the Reynolds number, or the hydraulic Reynolds number, for instance, is given as F over 2. Many graphs are present in this form. And you have that roughly in these two parts. You have a laminar part at low Reynolds number, which we don't have, and you have the turbulent part. Actually, you have a whole set of lines depending on how smooth the duct, the tube is. We're going to assume that these walls are all smooth, meaning that we need the lower line. We know our Reynolds number, so if you look at the real graph, you can read off at this Reynolds number, F over 2 is this value, which in this case would give F over 2 equals 0.002, if you read the graph. And thus, we need 4F. 4F equals 0.016. Now I can equate everything, which I will do. Delta P equals 4F that is 1.6, 10 to the minus 2, dimensionless, times the length, 10 meters, over the hydraulic diameter, 1.6, 10 to the minus 2 as well. A half rho is 10 to the third, v squared is 10 to the power 2. I can scratch these out. So I have 10 over 2 is 5 times 10 to the fifth Pascal, which is 5 bar. So there's quite a pressure drop over the 10 meter. And that is due to that actually the duct is narrow, as if it's a tube of 1.6 centimeters, less than an inch, and I flow at 10 meters a second through it, which is a pretty high velocity. Bottom line is that actually these type of calculations is pretty straightforward. If you want to find delta P and you have V, all you need to do is equate the hydrodynamic diameter, find Fanning's friction factor, and fill in your numbers. Try some yourself. You can cook them up very easily yourself.